sophomore Chavez Goodwin, their big man in conference play, is averaging 14 points, 6 boards, and 1 block a game. So they're looking to get him more involved, and he's leading the Southern Conference in field goal percentage. So James Dickey, Kyron Galloway are going to have their hands full tonight taking time to combat him.
In the first meeting, which we touched on, the Spartans were playing without two starters in that game, Kyron Galloway and Caleb Hunter. Neither one of them played in that double overtime loss in Spartanburg back in early January. We'll see how that affects this game. And for UNCG, at any rate, if you follow the Spartans, you know offensively Galloway makes a huge difference, as does a guy like Caleb Hunter. So UNCG in their home gold here tonight, as Goodwin will jump center with Galloway, and the Terriers will have it to start things off. Interesting matchup to keep an eye on is Malik Massey, pressure on the ball against Storm Murphy here. Murphy, Hoover, Stump, Hollowell, and Goodwin. Consistent five for Wofford.
Yeah, Wofford's going to run their stuff real well. Good to active hands, getting into deflection.
Spartans will push the other way here. Isaiah Miller, leading scorer for UNCG, to Galloway. There's that three from the corner. And the rebound run down, but almost stolen away there by James Dickey, and will head the other way.
Both defenses countering pretty well right now, trying to contain. This allows the Spartans, dead ball though, allows the Spartans to get into their press.
Be interesting to see if Wofford keeps taking care of the basketball like they have consistently throughout the course of the season against a Spartan team, which will turn you over almost 19 times a game. Hollowell looking for the back door to Hoover. It's not there. Swing it back out front to Goodwin with the shot clock winding down. Hoover's going to have to do it by himself. Launches a high arcing three, and a good defensive set by UNCG. Stolen away on the break. Here's Hoover. Terriers with numbers. Or check it. Murphy pulls up. Can't convert. Offensive glass. Missed opportunity by Goodwin. He'll get it back, and then the C's part, and he gets an easy one.
Yeah, everyone thought someone else was guarding the ball on the other end. Poor transition offense from the Spartans. Didn't have very good floor spacing at all. Pass was very easy to defend.
Miller drives, floats one up, and we're tied at two.
He's going to have to be careful. Wofford's one of the best teams at taking charges in the country. So he's going to go in there with his head up, eyes open, looking to make a pass.
Nearly stolen away by Miller on the quick leap. There's Dickey fighting for it, picked up by Miller. Numbers, kicks it out. Massey, open, three, good!
There it is, bury that one. All the time in the world to set that up. Wofford having a hard time just completing passes so far in full and half court.
Again, going backwards against this press, and two straight turnovers.
Well, I say it almost every game. It's one thing to prepare for it in practice. It's another thing to face it in reality. And it takes teams some time to adjust.
Jay McCauley immediately going to go to his bench and take out Trey Holloway and bring in the senior Donovan Thiem Love to work in the backcourt with Storm Murphy. Mo Abdul-Salam subs in for James Dickey for UNCG, and Miller just lost it on the way up. Stump has it the other way now. Hunter matched up on Hoover. That'll be something to keep an eye on. And then a foul off the ball and a offensive foul on Storm Murphy.
I didn't catch that one. Kind of extended his arm. One of the emphasis this week from the NCAA officiating crew was posting up, holding defensive players off with a straight arm. Maybe what Storm was called for.
Galloway tries to go inside. Errant pass taken away by Murphy, so Spartans will give it right back. Lining up for the three is Stump, and rolls it in. Trevor Stump came in having made 38 threes on the season, and if you know anything about Wofford, they will shoot threes. 11th in the country, making 261 now on the season. Massey gets tangled up, somehow finds Caleb Hunter. His three with an answer.
When the Spartans drive, whoever's putting the ball on the floor is going to have two, three, or four black jerseys to contend with. They've got to drive, looking to kick out, looking to drive, kick out repeatedly with discipline in order to make plays.
Hoover can't convert from the corner. Miller skies for the rebound. Spartans now into the front court, leading by three. Great
nice.
Find inside. Abdul Salam ran the floor, and Isaiah Miller found him.
Great patience inside. Good look from Isaiah, but great catch and finish. Just not forcing it, not rushing it. Abdul Salam just continues to grow inside offensively.
Goodwin is calling for it desperately. He'll have to kick it back out. Now resets, spins, and lays it in. Pretty move there by Chavez Goodwin.
Going to him against Abdul Salam. They think that's a mismatch. Massey trying to come down a double team. Going to get him out of the paint a little earlier.
They'll help off Massey. He'll fire a three. Misses it. Abdul Salam on the offensive glass. And whistled for the offensive foul on a push. And that'll bring with it our first media timeout. Exactly what you would expect from these two clubs. Heated play here in the opening minutes in the Greensboro Coliseum.
Yeah, sure, when opportunity knocks, you got to answer the door. But how do you get opportunity to knock in the first place? Well, you have to get noticed. And no one gets you noticed better than Matthews Mobile Media. Graphic advertising works, and Matthews Mobile has in-house graphic design and a production and installation team that can customize any vehicle or building advertising to support your growing business. Call Matthews Mobile Media today for a free estimate and get noticed.
Who's there?
Opportunity.
Thanks, Matthews Mobile Media.
Since 1917, Nieces has been hand-delivering our sausage fresh from our family to yours. For 100 years, we've used only the highest quality ingredients in the same family recipe that's been passed down for generations. Though the times will always change, you can be sure that one thing will stay the same. Nieces will be fresh, never frozen. Nieces, fresh has always been better.
Just underway here in Greensboro, Wofford and UNCG. And you get to this time of the year, they're all big ones, but a number of critical matchups tonight. ETSU and Furman playing. You see UNCG jockeying for that top spot. And Western Carolina, Wofford, Chattanooga, Mercer, really any one of those teams can slip up and be that fourth seed in the all-important Southern Conference tournament where the top four seeds get a bye.
Yeah, well, exactly. They want to make sure they're getting on top so they get that extra day of rest.
Full court pressure on this trip. Massey trying to make Murphy work with the basketball. Staying in front of him. Quick catch and shoot from Stump and rolls in another three. So Trevor Stump finding the range with two triples. Massey kicks it to Angelo Allegri. Just on the floor, and Spartans will back it out now. All tied at 10. Keyshawn Langley steps back. His three is off the mark. Rebound by Theme Love, and here come the Terriers.
You hear Coach Miller yell move in the background. They're not going to be successful if they don't have some cuts and some passes and some drives in their offense. If you just stand around, dribble, 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 and then shoot, that's exactly what Wofford wants you to do.
Theme Love drives, and somehow Hoover is wide open from the corner. He won't miss many of those, and then a rebound taken away by Messiah Jones.
Better be stronger than that.
Again, off a breakdown, Hoover's got it. He'll drive it in this time and able to convert off the glass, and the Terriers take the lead. This Wofford club coming into the game having lost three straight, all at home, but looking like they're full of confidence in their early going here tonight. Spartans content to launch threes. Dickey with the rebound. Great feed underneath
Hunter. Good cut from Hunter. Good Good find from Dickey. Waiting for the double team. Didn't come, but Hunter, back door.
Murphy will kick it out to Hoover. He'll drive. Little runner is up. Missed it. Dickey away with the rebound.
Well, Wofford's getting the shots they want. Spartans have been lucky that they've missed a couple here. Wofford's really executing well. It's always been their calling card.
Hunter tried to do it himself and clanked that one badly. Nice defensive set by the Terriers. A lot of standing around on the offensive end for UNCG. Messiah Jones kicks it out. Another wide open look, and this time Hoover is able to make it go down, and Wes Miller does not like it and is going to call a timeout. And Hoover, a guy who's attempted 221 three-pointers coming into this game, got to know where number 10 is on the floor. He's not going to miss many of them.
Not at all. This is a breakdown. It's been two or three breakdowns like that from the Spartans in the half court. Part of that is just how Wofford execute their offense, but really it's communication, especially when the bench is on that side. You don't see that very often from UNCG.
So off their three-point shooting, Wofford now out in front 15-12. You know, over these last three games, Darrell, that Wofford has lost, all three at home, they were shooting a combined 26 of 87 from three. That's just 29%. And for a team that really rests its hat on three-point shooting, shooting around 35%, it's going to be difficult to win ball games if you're not converting on those opportunities from beyond the arc.
Right, and you knew that Wofford was going to come in here tonight focused, angry, hungry. It was a matter of whether the Spartans were going to be able to rise to that challenge. So far, it's about even. But Wofford just has a little bit more focus right now.
Michael Hewitt on the court for the first time. Out to Isaiah Miller. His three is no good. And Wofford now with a chance to add to this three-point lead. Zion Richardson with it, and his pass deflected, taken away by Isaiah Miller. So quick. Miller feeding Langley. Now to Hewitt. Miller will drive, floats it up, didn't get the roll. Rebound controlled by the Terriers.
Well, Isaiah almost got another one. Sometimes it's like he's got four hands out there.
This is Isaiah Bigelow. Swings it to Hollowell. Quick three-pointer by Theme Love, and it's good. So the Terriers finding the range from outside, and that is just good medicine for Wofford fans as they lead it by six.
When they're not getting deflections and they're completing passes, they're executing their offense well, causing some problems for the Spartans.
Miller determined to get to the rack, kicks it to Allegri. Extra pass, Hewitt, his three.
Nice. That's what needs to happen. There's some contact inside. Isaiah's got back hurting right now, trying to call out.
Yeah, Isaiah Miller's really struggling, holding his lower back and asking to come out of the game. We'll keep an eye on that. He looks to be in some serious discomfort here with 11:43 on the clock and immediate timeout. Isaiah Miller to the bench. We'll check on his status here.
I switched to Chevy.
I switched for more room.
We switched.
Why do we switch?
For adventure.
For this.
See why people are switching to Chevy.
I'm never switching back.
Current qualified competitive lessees can lease this Trax for around $139 a month. Or current competitive owners get $3,750 total cash allowance when you purchase.
With TD Ameritrade, you've got courses, tools, and help from pros.
It's almost like you're training me to become an even smarter, stronger investor.
Exactly.
Left trade, right trade. Come on, another trade. I want to see it. More.
80s style training montage?
Yeah.
Happens all the time.
Well, three-point shooting, that's what Wofford is all about, and they've been getting good looks here.
They have. This is the way their offense is going. A lot of extra passes, looking to hunt threes in transition, and everyone on their team can play good. Theme Love, their backup point guard, he's shooting 42% from the three-point line in conference play, so they can all shoot. Spartans need to get out there, find shooters, communicate, challenge a shot, and make them put the ball on the floor.
Wofford 4 of 7 from three for the Spartans. You know, not a three-point shooting team, capable, but not a three-point shooting team. 8 of their first 13 shots here in the first half have been from beyond the arc.
And some of them have been really good in the part of the offense, but they've had two or three that just standing around and launching it, and that's playing into Wofford's hands. That's exactly what they want.
A little try down to the post to Abdul Salam. He'll kick it to Kobe Langley. Comes right back to Abdul Salam. Lost it. Dives on the floor to hustle. And a scramble, and we'll have a held ball. And the possession arrow should keep it on this end of the floor. And 6 seconds on the shot clock for UNCG.
Yeah. Mo that time had it, was looking around for something, but just Wofford, when you put the ball on the floor, there are going to be hands swiping from everywhere. The Spartans have to be stronger with the ball.
Shot clock at 4. Hewitt will launch one on his own, and it just to graze the net and go out of bounds. ...11-13 to play here first half. Wofford on the offensive end has been able to, when they have been able to not turn it over or get it across the timeline, gets the press, they've been effective. 5 of their last 7 possessions they've scored, and now make it 6 of 8 as Hoover's beginning to heat up.
They're running a lot of their sets off baseline runner action for Hoover, for Stump. Been very effective so far.
20-15, Wofford finding the shooting touch here in the Greensboro Coliseum tonight. Keyshawn Langley off a screen, and his pass kicked away. And we're talking a lot about Wofford's offense, but their defense has really caused some problems for the Spartans as well on this end.
Hard for the Spartans to get any clean action. Wofford's doing a good job of jamming the screens and cuts and doing a good job of ball pressure sort of from behind. If the Spartans have been a little too loose with the dribble or the handle or the catch, there's been a Wofford player there to cause some havoc. Nice three from Galloway.
Yeah, good setup by Isaiah Miller, who's returned to the court. Seems that back is okay. 2-point game as
Isaiah
we approach the midway point.
Yeah, Isaiah knows all eyes are on him. This might be a playmaking game for him versus a scoring game.
Goodwin going to drive in. And looked as if they were going to score the basket if it dropped in, but it's going to be a hold. Let's see what they end up doing. They'll call it on the floor. Just the second team foul on the Spartans. Abdul Salam will check out, and James Dickey returns. Team Love with a nice ball fake. His three is off the mark. James Dickey clearing away yet another rebound. Had 20 rebounds in the win at Mercer.
That's a lot
of
work.
That's 2-0-20. Kobe Langley to Hewitt. Hewitt will back it out. Langley trying to create, had it blocked, but hits the deck and a foul. Says Les Jones will come in on Wofford, and 2 free throws now for the freshman Kobe Langley.
Caught his defender kind of napping a little bit. Watch that hesitation, just right there, rocked him back. Wasn't quite expecting that burst of quickness. Good one-on-one move.
Foul actually going on Trey Hollowell. And here's Kobe Langley at the line. He's just 2 of 3 on the year.
Well, his brother can shoot free throws, so it's
to reason, right?
That, you know, being twins and all, that he should be able to knock them down too.
Keyshawn is twin brother, 89% on the year. Kobe saying, if I get there, I can make it too, right? Chance to tie it up if he can with this one. Left it short, though. That's on you, partner. again, over the top to the corner. This time James Dickey is there on Hoover. Now the 6'10", 6'11", Dickey way out on the perimeter pressuring Nathan Hoover. And Hoover's going to have to call the
ball pressure. How about that for ball pressure? That's a clinic right there. That's a 6'9 center, D'ing up a guard.
So Wofford will call the timeout and huddle it up. But that's really what the Spartans hang their hats on, however you want to say it, is their defense. And when their defense is creating pressure and turning you over, without question, that is when they are at their best.
It's both sides getting after it, though. I've been impressed with Wofford's half-court defense as well tonight. Both teams are having to work extra hard to get good looks. And so far, both teams, when they have gotten them, have been knocking them down. You expect a well-played game when these two teams get together. This one is so far meeting those expectations.
See the shot clock with six, now at five. Hoover again going to have to create, dropped it off inside, and at the buzzer, the dunk by Messiah Jones. But the officials, I think, initially waved it off. They want to take a look again. Great find by Hoover.
There's no light, so you can't tell.
There's a zero on the clock,
but you can't. There's no backboard light behind there. Both teams get a little break. Time to D it up. Good adjustment from Coach Miller, switching the zone.
That would call it a shot clock violation. Didn't get it off.
A good adjustment from Coach Miller to go to zone, kind of taking Wofford aback. Had to reset their offense. But then Wofford, with their discipline, executed a great play. Just a tenth of a second too late.
So the Spartans with a chance to take the lead here on this trip. Great
feed. Oh, what a play. Woo, what a play. Nice screen. Isaiah does such a great job of coming off ball screen so tight, leaving no room for his defender to get over the screen.
UNCG back in front now by one. Theme Love going nowhere in a hurry, in trouble, back to Hoover. Shot clock winding down.
Good switch. Good
stolen
switch.
Stolen away by Galloway. Trying to flip it ahead to Miller in his angst.
Almost.
That's one of those turnovers that the coaching staff can live with, though.
Yes.
You like the pressure. You like the intensity. And now the crowd here in the Coliseum starting to get into it a little bit. Wes Miller's team taking the lead by one. Nathan Hoover getting a breather here for Wofford. Stump returns. This is Storm Murphy with it now. Murphy lobs it inside. Basket good, and count it.
Great, her own pick and roll.
Messiah Jones, a freshman from Chicago, Illinois.
Nice shot fake. Both Dickey and Galloway went for the shot fake. Usually one goes. It's a good roll that time. Dickey should have came over. Kind of fell asleep for a second. Galloway fell for the shot fake. Said it himself. A good play from Wofford.
Messiah Jones averages 7 points, 4 rebounds a game. Steadily coming on as this year has progressed. Wofford as a team shoots 71% from the line. They don't miss a whole lot of them.
Wofford really looking at Goodwin and Jones inside, much more in their offense, trying to take the pressure off the guards to have to hit so many threes.
Zion Richardson matched up on Isaiah Miller. Hunter drives in, lost it, went off the leg of a Wofford player, and we've got immediate timeout. Both teams going at it here in Greensboro. The redshirt senior James Dickey trying to defend his home court. Spartans trailing by two, though.
Yeah, sure, when opportunity knocks, you got to answer the door. But how do you get opportunity to knock in the first place? Well, you have to get noticed. And no one gets you noticed better than Matthews Mobile Media. Graphic advertising works, and Matthews Mobile has in-house graphic design and a production and installation team that can customize any vehicle or building advertising to support your growing business. Call Matthews Mobile Media today for a free estimate and get noticed.
Who's there?
Opportunity.
Thanks, Matthews Mobile Media.
Since 1917, Nieces has been hand-delivering our sausage fresh from our family to yours. For 100 years, we've used only the highest quality ingredients in the same family recipe that's been passed down for generations. Though the times will always change, you can be sure that one thing will stay the same. Nieces will be fresh, never frozen. Nieces, fresh has always been better.
Half, you know, that talked about the Terriers coming in on a three-game losing streak, all three of those games at home. All three of those games they led by, I think, 10 points or more in the first half. They've been playing. They're not playing like a team which has dropped three straight. Certainly don't look like it here so far in the first half.
Yeah, you knew they were going to come in focused, ready to execute, hungry. These teams have a nice little rivalry over the past few years, so this is going to be intense.
Ball stolen away on the inbound pass. Donovan Thiemlove running the point with Storm Murphy on the bench. Murphy getting a rare breather. And Goodwin with it, operating on Dickey. Pounding goes up with a jump hook, left it short.
Nice one-on-one battle inside.
Miller weaving through traffic, had it swatted away from behind and picked up by the Terriers.
It's going to be very hard for him to go through top of the key to the rim the way Wofford plays defense.
Man's game underneath, bodies falling everywhere. Miller going to drive in, gets to that right hand, wouldn't roll in. He's slow to get up on the other end. The Terriers have numbers. Stump drives in. He'll kick it out to Hoover. He steps back, nowhere to go. Goodwin had it ripped away by Dickey as he hits the deck and falls down.
You're not going to see Wofford pass up too many transition threes the way they just did. Coach McCauley jumped about 5 feet in the air, wanting him to shoot that ball.
James Dickey gasped for the Spartans along with Isaiah Miller. They'll both check out. Keyshawn Langley will come in along with Kyren Galloway. 2-point lead for Wofford. 6:45 left to go here in the first. This is Bigelow, the Greensboro native. Langley hits the deck. No call on the screen, and then a foul on Massey. And you see over there, slow to get up. There is Keyshawn Langley.
Contact going around. You can see Keyshawn trying to get over, running into that leg. And then Massey trying to come over, allowing no easy ones. No easy ones tonight. Both teams aren't backing down.
Langley seems to be okay. And they called that foul on the floor prior to getting in the act of shooting. And Jay McCauley, the first-year head coach for the Terriers, doesn't really like that. Hoover forces one up. Allegri away with the rebound, and then in, and a foul will go on Allegri.
Held him underneath some kind of way, going up for that rebound. He had clean position underneath. Looks like he was holding. Yeah, you kind of see the hook right there. Good call by the official. Libre had him hooked underneath his arm. That's one of the things that the officials are looking for.
That's holding Bigelow there. Five team fouls on the Spartans. Two against Wofford. Inside to Goodwin. Got position and puts it in as the Terriers push the lead back out to four. Battle here in the first half, Greensboro Coliseum. Glad you're with us. Second meeting between the Terriers and the Spartans. Wofford won the first one in double overtime on their home court. Allegri going to drive in. Had it partially blocked, hits the deck, and a foul on Wofford.
It was good ball movement that time from the Spartans to create that angle. Allegri got to get there a little quicker. Wofford, we can see how Wofford's just trained to collapse on the ball. There's a drive. All of a sudden, there's two, three defenders crashing into Allegri.
Foul will go on Chavez Goodwin. And Angelo Allegri will have two here coming up for the free throw line from the sophomore from Kansas City. Angelo right around 76%. On the season. As a team, the Spartans shoot just 62% from the line. And you're shaking your head.
Yeah, every time it comes up. Every time it comes up.
Well,
positive thoughts tonight. Thinking positive thoughts.
Well, part of that is Isaiah Miller getting to the line as often as he does, and he shoots around 52% as Allegri goes 1 of 2, and then James Dickey right around the 50% mark as well. And something to keep an eye on as these games get more and more important.
Yep.
Under six to go, first half. 3-point lead for Wofford. Murphy back on the floor directing traffic as the shot clock whittles away. Deflected by Allegri, just couldn't hold on to it.
Allegri doing a good job fighting over the screens. One of the big points of emphasis for the coaching staff heading into this game. There's going to be so much action away from the ball. You have to fight over screens. You cannot let yourself be screened. Allegri with a perfect example of that right there.
Have to watch the shot clock here with four on it right now. Hollowell with one. Gets it off the glass. And did it hit the rim? I guess it did. Murphy had his shot blocked. Gets it back. Drives in. Had it blocked again. Scrambling for it underneath.
Blocks and blocks.
Last touch
and blocks.
By Wofford.
They had two or three players open on the perimeter. Coach McCauley saying pass the ball. Good help side defense from the Spartans.
Massey just trots it across the midcourt line. Spartans will try to spread the floor a little bit. Hewitt. Working around to Hunter. Seven on the shot clock for Allegri. Tries to do it himself. Up and under. Goes to the right hand.
Interesting. He drove. The help was initially there. Then once he picked up his dribble, the help went off. So it was just one-on-one in the post. Kept his pivot foot. Used his balance. Got to the basket. Allegri again kind of reading the pass.
Angelo Allegri. We talked about depth and bench. One of the things you touched on before the game, and he's one of those key guys off the bench for the Spartans and making a difference here in the last couple minutes.
Yeah, he's really done a good job of picking his spots, being patient, keeping the offense flowing, but then defensively reading screens, fighting over screens, trying to get those deflections. You see the depth we talked about earlier. The Spartans are going to need all of it tonight.
4:43 here in the first. Wofford with possession by leading by one.
Have a conversation there on the sideline.
Les Jones, a veteran official, waiting for everybody to get situated on the UNCG bench as they were inbounding it, just to make sure there was plenty of room. And there's a foul out on the perimeter on Langley. That's 16 fouls, so the next one will have the Terriers in the 1-1.
That's something they do really well. So the Spartans can't turn this into a free throw shooting contest, because that's one that the Spartans will not win.
Another slip to the goal, and they'll kick it out to Hoover. Corner three is no good and fouled. on the shot by James Dickey. And three free throws now for Nathan Hoover.
Yeah, Dickey's trying to get out there, couldn't control himself, kind of was drawn to the help. Great extra pass by the Wofford player to find Hoover in the corner.
At 92% on the year, comes in 78 of 84. You see, not a whole lot of people better than him from the line. Second in all of Division I basketball. And drops them in with ease. Lead is at four for Wofford. Hewitt underneath. Help side defense, had it blocked away by Messiah Jones, who's giving Wofford good minutes off the bench.
Yeah, Hewitt needed to go right up there, but great help side defense again from Wofford.
Long three by Hoover is off the mark, just a bit short. How has this pace been here so far in the first half? Who is it favored, would you say?
Well, it's really, Spartans haven't been able to get out and get this up and down the way I think they'd want to. It's very much in Wofford's favor, playing a half court on both sides.
Galloway, long three, and underneath. A foul will go on the Terriers. And it will be Spartan basketball. 4-point game here in the first half. Wofford leading on the road.
Switched. I switched to Chevy.
Wait.
I switched for more room.
We switched.
Why do we switch?
For adventure.
For this.
See why people are switching to Chevy.
I'm never switching back.
Current qualified competitive lessees can lease this Trax for around $139 a month. Or current competitive owners get $3,750 total cash allowance when you purchase.
With TD Ameritrade, you've got courses, tools, and help from pros.
It's almost like you're training me to become an even smarter, stronger investor.
Exactly.
Left trade, right trade. Come on, another trade. I want to see it. More.
'80s style training montage?
Yeah.
Happens all the time.
Over UNCG, after the Spartans, correct me if I'm wrong, I believe they had won six straight over the Terriers. Wofford's won the last four. This has been that kind of series in a way where one program gets upset with the other one, so they win a bunch of games, and the other program says, I've had enough of that.
Right.
Let's come on back and win some. And right now it has been in the Terriers' favor. They won the Southern Conference Tournament Championship last year against UNCG. And here in the first half, Wofford shooting just about 48%. And 4 of 9 from three with Galloway at the line.
You know, interestingly enough, look at the stats. The turnovers are dead even. And it's Wofford with the major advantage, points off turnovers, 12-5. That's been the Spartans' calling card all year long.
Galloway knocks them all in, and we've got a one-point game.
Somewhere along the line, there was a foul on a three that we didn't see.
Stolen away by Langley to Hunter.
Oh, get in there. Oh, get in there.
Great feed from Hewitt, who found Caleb Hunter. And UNCG off their defense, leading by one.
You know, UNCG streaky offensively. When they can get points off turnovers, it really gets them going. And then the shots start falling.
Stump for three, had it spin out.
Good transition defense from Wofford.
Langley to Dickey. He's going to back his way in. Has some size in the post, but doesn't have the ball where he wants it, so kicks it out.
He's going to get deeper.
Spartans' patience on this trip with the shot clock ticking away. Hunter kicks it out. Langley, his three, off the mark. Dickey on the offensive glass, then had it taken away. And quick hands by Wofford as James Dickey was thinking dunk there.
And Wofford's been doing that all game long. They've been really taking chances on going after the dribbler, whether it's on the perimeter or inside. And that's probably the fifth time I think they've knocked the ball away. Spartans have to be stronger knowing that hands are coming from anywhere.
29-28. Spartans on a 6-0 run. Miller nearly had another one. And the Terriers over the top to Hoover, and his three is good. Wasn't pretty for Wofford, but they'll take it as Hoover knocks in the triple to put the Wofford club up by two.
When teams have had success against the press, it's been by throwing it over the top. There have been a few non-conference opponents that have been able to put shooters in the corner and had some effectiveness.
What a find by Langley up top. Zip it in there to Dickey.
And he noticed that time Dickey didn't put a ball on the floor. He just went straight up with it.
Tied at 31 with under two to go. First half. Well, it's a tough guard from Galloway. That height out there on Hoover. Can he stick with him? Hoover going to drive by. Kicks it to the corner to Stump. Drive and pitch. And the threes are working for Wofford.
They are. They can drive and kick, drive and kick. There's shooters everywhere.
Stump has made three threes now, 34-31.
Spartans have to do a better job of stopping the initial drive.
Tried to hit Dickey cutting down the lane, pass a little too quick. Here comes Wofford, right back to Stump, feeling it tonight. Misses that one. Dickey tried to save it. Hoover rejected by Galloway, who closed so quickly. Spartans have numbers if they push the other way. Miller through traffic, sets up Langley. Thought about the three, he'll go baseline. Floater is up and good.
Good decision, good decision. You know, Wofford's making all the plays on defense, coming up with some stops, coming up with some steals, and they're kind of doing it within their game plan. The Spartans are working so hard to get a challenge shot or a block or make up for a mistake. Let's hope that doesn't wear the Spartans down eventually. It's usually the Spartans that are wearing teams down.
Stump's pass deflected by Dickey, but he picks it up. Shot clock at five. Hoover off a screen, has some distance, spins out. Dickey hits the deck off the foul by Goodwin. Here with 16 seconds left. And both clubs looking a little gassed here right now.
It's a physical game on both sides. You know, Wofford only has, let's see, I think five personal fouls. It's a little too early. I wonder if they get something they don't like, the foul, to have the Spartans reset their action. Usually you don't see that in the first half, but the Terriers have the option.
Shot clock not moving now. See if they recognize it. They're going to play on. Started a little bit late. Dickey goes to the jump hook, a little bit strong. And they're going to play on.
The Spartans could have played for the last shot, didn't. Got fortunate there.
Miller will heave it.
I don't know what that was. I think Coach Miller wanted the last shot, but maybe Dickey was so wide open they just couldn't help it.
Well, both teams laid it out there. Isaiah Miller and company, though, going to walk into the locker room, trailing here by one at the half to a hot shooting Wofford club. Halftime on the way here after this.
Fire TV Cube? Alexa, turn on the TV. Plain Chopped on Food Network. Let's volume up.
We made USAA insurance for busy veterans like Kate. So when her car got hit, she didn't waste any time. She filed the claim on her USAA app and said, that was easy.
They are ready to pack it in by any stretch of the imagination, nor would you think they would. And leading here by one as we start the second half. Here's Storm Murphy with it. Did not score in the first half. The junior point guard who averages 12 a game.
One of the other good things for the Spartans on the shot, on the sheet, is a good offense from Wofford there. There's no Spartans in foul trouble. Usually we're talking about two and three fouls at this point, but everyone's pretty clean. Just Mo Abdul-Salam has two, so Spartans can be really aggressive on the defensive side of the floor.
Miller kicks it to the corner to Galloway. Steps into a three and knocks it home. What a shot.
He took
by Kyren Galloway.
His consistent shot made it more difficult. That's crazy.
Ties it up here at 36 apiece. Immediately the shooters flatten to the corners. There's Hoover. Three is good. Makes another one. Hoover has been on target. He's got 16 now. And his third made three. Miller, you just sense he's trying to get himself going. Little floater is no good. Dickey on the offensive glass. Keeps it, goes up with it, and scores over Goodwin.
Big emphasis. Spartans wanted to kill them on the offensive rebounds. Hadn't done it so far. I think Coach Miller would rather have them hit the first shot, but they've got to be more aggressive on the offensive glass.
Murphy over to Hoover. He'll drive it in on Galloway, scoops it in, and UNCG has not had an answer for Nathan Hoover.
Excellent job by Hoover of drawing the defender out, then putting the ball on the floor and making it happen.
Miller tries to step into a three and airballs it. Now 1 of 5 from the floor. Averaging 18 a game. Hollowell will penetrate, kicks it to Hoover. Another three. This one no good. And Galloway rustles it away.
Being strong with the ball. But you can see the simplicity of the Terriers' offense, how they're breaking the press, using a ball screen in the middle of the floor, and kicking it to the corners. They're getting good looks every time down.
Wofford lead is at three. Miller drops it off to Dickey, lays it in, but they'll call the whistle and a foul on the floor on a bump on Storm Murphy, and that will be his second.
Murphy read it, just got there a little too quick and instinctively put two hands on the cutter. Referees are going to call that every time.
Galloway kicks it out to Dickey. Tries to go by Goodwin and just didn't get that angle. Trying to draw the third personal foul on Goodwin, who runs the floor now. Hoover had a notion there before Galloway finally picked him up. Murphy stops, pops, jump shot is good. That's his first bucket of the game. Wofford coming out with confidence to start the second half. Stretching the lead out to 5 now. Miller trying to go down to the post, sweeps through the lane, tough shot, missed it.
Yeah, a lot of the Spartan offense is one pass and going isolation, whereas Wofford's getting up
run
and down.
The break, but Murphy couldn't finish it. Missed it on the break, and Spartans don't like the way this second half is going in a quick timeout by Wes Miller.
A smart timeout. No continuity for UNCG so far on the offensive side, where Wofford's getting any shot they want.
43-38, Terriers lead it with this timeout.
These are the student athletes. This is where they battle. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. This is where titles are forever. This is the Southern Conference.
Never has it been a better time to join the Spartan family. For as little as $100, you can join the Spartan Club and power the success of our student athletes. Visit SpartanClub.org today. The Spartan Club, supporting student athlete success since 1986.
Good night. Good night.
Hey, I was watching that.
You've seen it like 10 times.
You've seen it 10 times.
I drive the carpool in the morning.
Yeah, we both have to get up early.
Just turn it back on.
Okay.
Sometimes you just have to move. Penske Truck Rental. Free and limited miles on one-way rentals to keep you moving forward.
Room and out of that huddle as they've pushed the lead out to five, and a club which is very dangerous, as we know, and they are playing with a great deal of confidence, seem very sure about what they want to do out here on the court.
We're getting the shots they want and the places they want. Now it's just a matter of whether it's going to go down or not. And so far this half it has been. It's really kind of put UNCG back on their heels a little bit, because the Wofford defense, a perfect antidote for our offense. Not getting a lot of continuity so far. Let's see what Coach Miller has come up with.
We had a long conversation with Isaiah Miller, did Wes Miller, in that timeout. Spartans are going to go inside, and James Dickey able to convert.
Well, that's something they've really started to do the last two or three games, is really start to anchor their offense through him. One-on-one in the post, he's a tough guard.
Murphy shut off by Isaiah Miller, now backs it out. Here's a drive, theme love, lost it, turnover. Galloway picks it up, he'll rifle it to Hunter. Hunter gonna challenge, goes up, layup is good.
Good right hand too, excellent job. They were playing him to go to his left. Good job of taking what the defense gives you.
The Spartans quickly cut that lead down to one. Again, they lose sight of Hoover, steps inside the arc this time. Missed it though, and is it a foul or a jump ball underneath? Let's see.
Black ball time out. Both teams going for it. Somehow called the timeout. Good play from Wofford. Let's take a look at it here. And the defense on the turnover. Defense to offense. That's how the Spartans are going to get back in this.
The Domino's Tracker now has GPS with delivery alerts, so we don't catch you before you're ready.
Hey, time of your life, huh, kid?
It's about to be.
Try it next time you get any two or more medium two-topping pizzas delivered for just $5.99 each.
As I was walking a ribbon of highway, I saw above me an endless skyway. I saw below me,
beyond all maps, where no one's been.
This land was made for you and me.
There is a place we could be free.
We did PG.
Well, it all points to March 5th through 9th in Asheville, North Carolina, the Southern Conference Tournament at Harris Cherokee Center. We'll be there, have good seats. Invite you to join us. You can catch all the action streaming live on the ESPN app. And has the making for another really, really good tournament. A lot of parity in the league this year.
Yeah, and a lot of games just like this one right here. You can just feel the intensity. It's got that March feel to it. Both teams going back and forth. This is going to come down to the very end.
Wofford will have it inbounding along the baseline. Flip it right back to Theme Love. Now to Hoover off a set. He's open. Three this time. No good. And let's see. Little scramble for it and picked up by Massey. Massey's got his head down. Wants to take it. And we'll head to the line. 4-2 here.
No matter who wants the ball more, it's both teams had shots at it. Massey comes up with it cleanly. You can see both teams going after it. Wofford gets it first. Spartan stick with it. Massey pushes it ahead. No one really stopped ball, so kept going until the referee blew the whistle.
And there have been a number of those plays where someone has it, one team has it,
right.
Another team comes in, pokes it away. The ball almost changes hands 2 to 3 times before it. It's been that game of who wants that ball
right.
Sometimes more, right?
Could it be stronger? We saw one of the last rebounds that Galloway had went through three people and just out-muscled Wofford for the ball. He didn't have the advantage, but he just wanted it more.
Massey knocks them both in. 6-0 run for the Spartans now to take the lead here at 44-43. Confusions on the substitutions here, but they will bring out Hoover and bring Storm Murphy back on the floor.
Wofford a chance to reset. Apparently the Spartans didn't want to.
So after leading by five, UNCG, or trailing by five, UNCG responds. Taking the lead here at 44-43. Malik Massey's done a really good job on the steady Storm Murphy here tonight. Miller pressuring. Bigelow will swing it back out. Shot clock winding down now. Challenge at the rim and a great feed underneath to Jones.
Great play on that side. Galloway couldn't stay in front. The ball handler, so Dickey had to come over and help. It's great. Break it down. Two-man basketball on the sideline.
Puts Wofford back up by one. Dickey doubled. They'll leave it now. Doubled again. Kicks it out. Miller's open. His three off the mark. Just can't find the range now. 1 of 7 for the leading scorer for the Spartans.
Now they're going to continue to play off him on the perimeter and say, go ahead and make a three. They're going to live with that.
Messiah Jones, who's been aggressive, puts his head down. And, yeah, that'll be an offensive foul on the freshman from Chicago.
Yeah, Dickey was holding his position. Keeping distance, moving his feet. When you dip that shoulder to go into the defensive player, there's contact on both sides. You can see Dickey backing off, put his shoulder through a little bit of an elbow too, just to clear some space. Referee saw all he was going to see.
Isaiah Miller, Kyren Galloway will sub out for UNCG. Keyshawn Langley, along with Angelo Allegri, return. Spartans possession trailing by one.
I'd like to see the Spartans get on a little 5-0 run or something like that here. Push a little distance out. This is the time of the game they need to.
They leave Langley open. His three wouldn't go down. Dickey's been a workforce here on the glass as he saves that possession.
How did he stay in bounds on that? Had the tippy toes. Just wanted the ball.
9 rebounds now for James Dickey.
I think he's trying to go after working towards 2,000 rebounds. Close to a push-off there.
Allegri shut off, keeps moving though, and draws a foul. Just kept that pivot foot down and pivoting away until the defense got off balance and did that one time in the first half too.
Yeah, just a little isolation. Coach Miller sees something he likes in the Allegri matchup out there. It's the third time he's gone to him with an isolation play.
Spartans from the free throw line, 7 of 9. That rattles out for Allegri. He's now 1 of 3 from the line. Allegri, a guy who stepped in the starting lineup when Caleb Hunter was out, the ankle injury, and has played good, steady minutes all year for the Spartans, but leaves two out on the floor. Yeah. After those misses. Stay at a 1-point lead for Wofford. Goodwin with great possession off the catch and rolled it in. Wofford by three now.
Good pick and roll offense. They can do more things inside. And Goodwin's in the game. When he's not in the game, they really have to be more perimeter oriented.
Hunter, deep three, missed it badly. Terriers trying to add to the three-point lead, and Goodwin got ahead of the pack, but Dickey saved it with the block. And then a late whistle came in, I think.
Yeah, I think they called a foul on Dickey. A little too much body after the block, I believe. Crowd don't like it.
They're not going to win that battle against this crowd in the Greensboro Coliseum. Watch again as...
Good job of Goodwood running out. Huh. Get some contact there. Almost seemed like... And that's what caused him that contact.
Well, Goodwin, who shoots just 48% from the line, knocks that in. And the Wofford bench able to get the lead back for the Terriers and extend it here now. And a chance to push it right back out to 5 points. So Wofford responding with a little 6-0 run of their own.
We talked about the Spartans needing to get a little breathing room there with Wofford that did that. Important stage of the game.
Isaiah Miller.
You can see where
searching,
it's...
forces it up, missed it badly, and he just cannot get a shot with two defenders around him. And meanwhile, let's see who that's going to go against. Offensive foul on Wofford as Langley able to jump to the spot.
Great job transition defense that time, but offensively, you can see here Langley there. Just gets run right over. Didn't have the most perfect position, but just lowering the shoulder, knocking him out. The referee's going to call that on the offense. For the Spartans offensively, you saw that last possession. Isaiah was essentially going 1-on-5. No passes. Can't do that against this Wofford defense.
Miller will give it up to Allegri. He'll step back, shot clock at 10. Allegri, again, a lot of one-on-one for the Spartans. Great feed, though, by Allegri to Abdul Salam.
Fine. You know, one of the things I'm noticing, and especially in this game, is every time Isaiah touches the ball stops. He's got to know ahead of time whether he has an angle or not. He's got to keep the ball flowing of the offense and wait to get it back if there's not immediate drive there. The ball is stopping too often when it reaches his hands.
Goodwin kicks it out. He'll swing it to the corner. Open three is off the mark by Stump. Allegri hits the deck. And that'll be a foul on Goodwin. And that is his third personal foul.
Going after the ball.
By three.
Man's game tonight.
Only our number one decision. So that's my first foul, general fail. It was like a love at first sight brick for sure. I love to give recommendations, see somebody else use my brick just based on a picture or seeing my house like that. To me, it's exciting.
Geico makes it easy to get help when I need it. With licensed agents available 24/7, it's not just easy. It's having Jerome Bettis on your flag football team easy. Go get him, bus!
Ooh. Come on, bus. Come on. Hey, wait. I got your flag, man.
It's Geico easy. Yeah. With licensed agents available 24/7.
49-0!
More than 500 physicians and providers, 30 medical specialties, 100 locations, all with a single goal, to help you feel your best. Cone Health Medical Group works collaboratively to ensure students, faculty, and families get access to the right care with the right provider, in the right place, at the right time. With offices close to where you live or work, you'll find a partner focused on helping you prevent illness and improve your overall health and well-being. For more information on exceptional care in your neighborhood, visit chmg.com.
And you see all the help defense to converge on him, and that's the way to attack the way Wofford's playing defense.
And you see Mo doesn't put the ball on the ground, doesn't dip it too badly. So quick catch, quick finish. Good job from Allegre drawing defenders and then kicking it out. But that's going to be that kind of offense is just really difficult to execute over and over again and get good quality shots. Spartans need to spread that floor out. Get screens, get cutters, get movement, and make the offense and the shots just easier.
Well, it's been hard to get the good shots for the Spartans in the second half. They're just 5 of 13, 38.5%. Wofford, meanwhile, 6 of 11, almost 55% shooting here in the second half. It'll be Allegri, Keyshawn Langley, Mo Abdulsalam, Isaiah Miller, and Michael Hewitt, the 5 on the floor on offense. Miller will get a screen, swings it to Allegri. Stops, pops, jump shot, no good. And a foul on Isaiah Miller right there at the midcourt line. That'll be the, second or third team foul on the Spartans.
That's the second.
Second on the Spartans. Wofford has 6 whistles against them. .11:35 left. It has been a battle tonight here in the Greensboro Coliseum. Hewitt out on Hoover. Touch for Jones. Hoover steps back into a jump shot. He's been quiet lately. Wouldn't go down. Ball loose on the floor. Abdulsalam will pick it up.
Really
Miller weaving through traffic, goes glass, still will not go down for Isaiah Miller. Those are shots he usually makes in traffic.
Yeah, he's starting to press now. He's just going to be playmaker. The shot isn't there. Don't force it. Kick it out. Set it up again.
Murphy spinning away and then had it taken away. Uncharacteristic turnover. Langley now trying to make something happen. Draws a foul, and that'll be 17 fouls on Wofford now. And 1-1. For the Spartans.
Well, Langley's the one guy we want on the free throw line. 89%, I think, from the free throw line.
Langley comes in 35 of 39 and 89%.
I know a couple of those he's really upset at himself missing.
I think he missed 2 the other game.
Yeah, right? He's really upset.
Knocks that one in. Wofford hasn't scored in the last 2.5 minutes or so. The Spartans just 1 of their last 7, so we've been hanging around this 3-4 point mark the last couple minutes. Langley draws the Spartans to within 1 now.
Yeah, normally Spartans, this is about the time when they start wearing teams down, but Wofford goes deep onto their bench as well. So they may not have the same effect as they have on most opponents because Wofford goes 8 or so deep.
Stump having trouble, just does get it inbounds. Kobe Langley now on the floor. He'll pick up full court on Murphy. Spartans really aggressive on the ball defensively. And a good example of it there as Kobe Langley knocks it out of bounds. 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Look for Wofford to take advantage of that. They tried to backdoor that time, just a little bit of miscommunication. If Wofford does back cut, watch how UNCG defends it.
Allegri went for the steal, but no whistle there. Shot clock now at 5 for Murphy. He'll drive. Free throw line jump shot is good. Just good offense there by Storm Murphy.
One-on-one strong take.
Makes his second buck here in the half. 51-48. halfway through the first half. These two longtime rivals set for another good one here tonight. Miller drives and kicks to Allegri. Three, grazed the front iron.
Yes, that offense is easy to defend for Wofford. Just stop one drive, close out one shot.
Hollowell had it blocked by Abdul Salam. Miller picks it up. Looks like he wants to go to the rim. Kicks it out to Hewitt. Spartans will reverse it. Langley drives and kicks. Hewitt steps into a three, no good. And last touch by Wofford and out of bounds. I feel like this crowd is just waiting for something to happen for UNCG to erupt. Spartans have had some looks.
Well, credit
Wofford. Haven't been able to make that big shot.
Right? Well, and credit Wofford. Every time the Spartans make a play or make a little run, Wofford has a great answer.
Miller lines up a three. Got it to go. Let's see if that gets him going. Tied at 51 now. Just his second made field goal of the night. Hewitt falls to the deck. Gets right back up. Hoover's been quiet here of late. He's operating. Drives, spins, fires. And a timeout at the Wofford bench.
Tough shot, tough shot.
Hoover eyeing up Hewitt as he walks the other way.
I think Hewitt was talking to him on the floor, so Hoover just answered.
53-51, Wofford. Nathan Hoover spins, steps back, and knocks in the jumper. Gives him a little look afterwards. And Hoover now with 20 on 7 of 19 shooting. He's had to work for it, but he has 20 of their 53 points here.
Senior stepping up in a big road game. You know, they lost three in a row. He's going to do everything possible to make sure it's not four. That's what seniors do. Get out there, lead the charge, put the team on his back.
Well, you said it was a good answer by Hoover after Isaiah Miller hits that three. The crowd starts to get into it a little bit. But that shot was much like Murphy's was. Get to the free throw line, pull up and make a little mid-range jump shot. Dickey trying to clear out the post. Now he'll operate, jump stop, up, layup is good for James Dickey.
It's a weapon that very few teams in the Southern Conference have, a five-man. You can set a ball screen for, can do something with it with the ball in his hands.
We are tied again. Massey nearly stole it away, but Hoover ends up picking it up. Off a screen, Hoover turns the corner. High arcing jump shot is good. He's got a little bounce in his step now.
Feeling it. Wofford's just going to load him up with shots the rest of the way.
He's had a way of having big games against UNCG and has another one brewing here. Miller rises and fires off the mark. Hoover away with the rebound. 7:45 and ticking away. Hollowell for three, swished it home. Wofford has had an answer every time UNCG has tried to make a run, and they do it again to push the lead one more time out to five. Wofford bench is fired up. The Spartans huddling up on the other end, looking a little like they're searching for answers right now. 7:26 left to go.
It's not a weekend trip.
15 minutes away.
Oh, fine, I'm going to take off.
Now, you downloaded the TD Ameritrade mobile app so you can quickly check the markets?
Yeah, actually, I'm taking one last look at my dashboard before we board.
Excellent. And you have Thinkorswim Mobile?
So I can finish analyzing the risk on this position.
You two are all set. Have a great flight.
Hey, thanks.
We'll see ya. Okay. Ah, they're getting so smart.
Choose the app that fits your investing style.
Shots fired, I'm going in, standing alone for the moment. Wow, he's up, this fight is a draw.
2, Saturday. Buy now on pay-per-view or ESPN+.
Guard is when you can shoot the three, it just creates so many other opportunities for you on the offensive end.
Well, the Wofford's designed their offense around getting him looks, number one, any way you can, but such a skilled player, can put the ball on the floor, can make things happen at the basket, create his shots on the perimeter, knock down open threes, and again, a senior doing senior things, does not want to see his team lose four in a row. He's going to do everything he possibly can to make that happen.
And via the last couple baskets by Hoover, Wofford has pushed the lead back to five. Had it at five, Spartans fought back. Wofford pushed the lead out again. Spartans tied it up at 51 apiece, and here we stand, and an offensive foul on Malik Massey on a push-off on the baseline.
You were trying to have a little sideline pick and pop for Galloway, and Massey saw something on the baseline that he liked. Let's take a look at it here. Refused the ball screen. Yeah, a little push-off right there. Massey wasn't going anywhere anyway. When you leave your feet like that on the baseline, it leads to trouble.
Hoover will calm things down. And Wofford leading by five with still a lot of time left with 7 minutes left to go. Goodwin breaks his way to the basket, and Dickey with no choice but to foul him there.
Wofford spreading the ball around, going four around. Really no one, putting five around the perimeter allows that pick and roll opportunity.
For James Dickey, that's his third, as Chavez Goodwin will head to the line.
Dickey's out there guarding Stump. Well, he's got a shade to the three-point line. That gives Goodwin a lot of room inside.
Goodwin perfect from the free throw line, 3 of 3. Again, he shoots just 48%. Must like the rims here, though. And the Spartans almost lost it out of bounds. 59-53.
One of those nights for the Spartans, just not playing clean on the offensive side of the ball.
Offense going through James Dickey now. Kicks it out to Galloway. He's got a good look at it. Too strong. And that'll be a foul on Wofford on a hold underneath on Hoover, who had grabbed Caleb Hunter. That's the second of the game on Nathan Hoover. 6:36 left, but it's plenty of time if you're a UNCG fan, but you still start to feel a little anxious, like, you know, you got to get something going here as the Wofford team is a program which does not beat itself very often.
No. And although the Spartans have closed the gap on the turnovers and have the advantage again, their offense has just really been stagnant. So it's good to get that kind of break to go to the line, see a couple go through. They can set up their press. Maybe they can get a deflection. Maybe start get some offense out of defense. And just kind of go, start running up and down a little bit.
Theme love and all kinds of trouble. And UNCG nearly gets the steal. Ends up in Hoover's hand. He'll rifle it out. Theme love on the drive. And the pass. Let's see, last touch by Wofford.
Yeah, the Spartans had the turnover, but the ball bounces to Wofford the first time. Spartans stick with it defensively, something you don't have to remind them to do. That's in their DNA. Forced to turn over the second time.
Down by four. Again, offense going through Dickey. He's going to back his way in on Goodwin. Spins, rises, hangs, and falls off the rim. Under six left to go now. Hoover off a screen, lines it up, missed it though.
Yeah, I think everybody thought that was going in.
Langley
deep
way
three.
Outside.
I don't think that's the kind of offense that Coach Miller is looking for right there.
Five.
No rebounders left. In position or anything.
4-point game. And another Wofford turnover. Well, the door is open for UNCG. Can they get the look they want on this end?
a tough shot that time. Tough shot. No, again, no rebounders. That one happens to go in.
Caleb Hunter with four straight. Crowd rising here in the Coliseum. Theme Love. Can he answer? Missed it. Stump has the rebound. And he'll back it out. Under five left to go. Here's Goodwin operating on Dickey. Had it blocked by Dickey. And now UNCG with a chance to tie or take the lead on this trip.
Composure. Need to play with composure here. Execute their offense.
UNCG with four players waiting to come in at the scorer's table. Where do you go on this trip? Hunter's been the hot hand lately. Dickey has some space. Elected not to shoot that one. Now he'll operate. Muscles it in, and we're tied.
Go to him. Go to him. Isaiah's on the sideline, chomping to get back in, doing jumping jacks, getting the crowd in there. Got to be disciplined. Got to execute.
Tied at 59.
Got to stay with Hoover, too.
Wofford trying to get him the basketball.
Caleb's done a great job on him the past two or three possessions.
Shot clock at 10. Hoover rises, lets it ride. Missed it. And Galloway and Dickey out battle himself. And here's James Dickey nodding his head against the backstop there. 3:51 left. James Dickey, the redshirt senior, doing it on both ends of the floor. Wofford basketball when we come back.
T-Mobile's new offer on iPhone 11 is even better on our newest, most powerful signal. Switch to T-Mobile now and get two lines of unlimited for only $90 and two iPhone 11s on us. Only at T-Mobile.
We switched. I switched to Chevy. Hey.
I switched for more room.
We switched.
Why do we switch?
For adventure.
For this.
See why people are switching to Chevy.
I'm never switching back.
Current qualified competitive lessees can lease this Trax for around $139 a month. Or current competitive owners get $3,750 total cash allowance when you purchase.
You know what beats next day shipping? Getting it the same day. With Ace, you can buy online and get free in-store pickup or get it delivered that day. Around the block, what you need in stock with people who know their stuff.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
It's a 13-hour flight. That's not a weekend trip.
15 minutes.
Oh, wow. I gotta take off.
Now, you downloaded the TD Ameritrade mobile app so you can quickly check the markets?
Yeah, actually, I'm taking one last look at my dashboard before we board.
Excellent. And you have Thinkorswim Mobile?
So I can finish analyzing the risk on this position.
You two are all set. Have a great flight.
Hey, thanks.
We'll see ya. Ah, they're getting so smart.
Choose the app that fits your investing style.
It has been a 6-0 run over the last 2 minutes, 45 seconds or so for the Spartans to tie this game up here at 59. And Wofford will have it here out of this timeout. We'll see what set Jay McCauley runs, but you got to figure number 10 in black is going to be involved in some way.
Yeah, you figure in this lineup, some changes for the Spartans. Isaiah's got to be one guarding him, ball hawking him the entire time.
3:52 left. Storm Murphy will inbound it.
Dickey taking a break on the corner.
Stump lets it go. Missed it. Rebound, Isaiah Miller.
Good defense from Galloway on the closeout, forcing him to sidestep the shot and take a rush challenge shot.
Miller weaving through traffic, trying to find a little path. Skips it over to Allegri for the lead.
In and out.
Allegri had a good look at it. Murphy swings it to Hoover. Galloway reached. Couldn't get it. They'll scramble and last touched by Isaiah Miller out of bounds. Hoover has missed his last couple, but he's had
he's got good
defenders
looks.
Flying at him too.
Yep. And been much better. He hasn't had those open looks like he had the first 6-7 minutes of the half.
Wholesale substitutions for Wes Miller's group. 3:17 left. Tiki out on stump. Massey denying. Out on the perimeter. Miller's on Hoover. Stump nearly turned it over. Spartans had it. They'll kick it out. Three ball by Hollowell. Clanked it. Abdul Salam battling for it. Bodies on the deck. And Goodwin will hustle and call a timeout.
Man, everyone jumping everywhere. This ball got kicked a little, spun a little, just ended up in Goodwin's lap. Smart play to call a quick timeout.
2:56 left and a 30-second timeout. Look again at the scramble.
Scramble, hustle, everyone has it. Abdul Salam needs to get on the floor there. That's what Coach Miller is going to tell him in the video room when they watch it tomorrow. Mo's got to be on the floor. He can't be reaching down to grab that ball.
Good alert move there by Chavez Goodwin. Ball rolled into his leg. Just pull that thing in and call a timeout. Timeout by Wofford. Look here at our conference standings. Wofford and UNCG both trying to move up if they can. These critical game here.
About 6 minutes to go in Johnson City. East Tennessee State up about 8 points on Furman.
And a battle for first place there. Now here we have 2 minutes, 56 seconds left. UNCG trying to get another stop. Goodwin can't hand it off. Now he'll go to the rack, puts his head down, and just slipped by Abdul Salam.
It was a nice set to get a one-on-one set for Goodwin. That whole play was designed for him to get the ball going to the basket.
2:40 left. Now it's up to UNCG to answer on this end. Isaiah Miller can't quite turn the corner. Now he'll post up Murphy. Rifles it out. Hunter for the lead. Wouldn't go down. And the rebound into Murphy's hands.
Good look that time from Caleb.
Hoover calling for it. Lost it off his leg off the quick defensive closeout by Massey.
Yeah, he went before he had a clean look at the ball. Pressure starting to get to him. The defensive pressure, this is what happens late in the game. You don't really even realize it. You start rushing through your plays that you were doing at normal speed earlier to try to beat that Spartan pressure.
Dickey, one-on-one with Goodwin. Turns for the tie, and up to the free throw line he will go. And that is four now on Chavez Goodwin. And James Dickey. We'd look again here.
Banging inside. I think maybe the right arm inside. Came down a little bit, kind of got stuck on Dickey, I think.
Yeah, I think they called him the inside arm.
Yeah.
And James at the line, 52% on the year. A chance to tie it up here on his home floor. Spartans now 11 of 16 from the line. Wofford is 7 of 8.
You can see that graphic, 342nd in Division I in free throw shooting.
And misses them both. Miller nearly had the rebound, but Hoover away with it. Lead still stands at 2. Spartans missed a good look from 3 and then 2 free throws there. Galloway in the passing lanes.
Put so much pressure on your defense in games like this when you can't make your free throws.
Shot clock under 10. Wofford working their set. Stump finding Hoover. Turns, steps back. Jump shot is short. And the Spartans will go the other way with a chance to tie or take the lead.
Massey did a great job of sliding underneath that screen and being right in Hoover's shoes when he caught that ball. He thought he was going to put the ball on the floor. Had no place to go. Dickey comes over to help.
Crowd on their feet. Miller for the lead, no good. Settled outside maybe. And a reach-in foul on UNCG, and it'll go on Caleb Hunter. That's the fifth team foul now. Miller clean look at it, not known as a three-point shooter, and went for the home run shot there. Well, maybe.
Again, shooting the shot that Wofford wants him to shoot.
Isaiah just 2 of 12 from the floor, 1 of 5 from 3. Spartans have not scored since the 4:15 mark when they tied it up at 59 apiece. Wofford with the one bucket from Goodwin. Chance to make it a two-possession game now for Wofford. Under a minute left. Murphy calling for it. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Murphy lines it up. Shot is no good, and Hunter away with the rebound. Another chance here for the Spartans to tie or take the lead. Oh, underneath Hunter, almost lost it. 13 seconds left on the shot clock, and Wes Miller not seeing this possession develop the way he wants to, and he's going to call a timeout as UNCG almost turned it over.
Well, they ran some action that was a back pick for Caleb to go to the basket. Caleb had a step on him, and that's what Isaiah saw, but Caleb wasn't running as if he was cutting to the basket. He was just kind of running the action. Very fortunate that that ball didn't go traveling out of bounds. Somehow Malik Massey comes up with it, so a great timeout from Coach Miller with 12 seconds left on the shot clock when you need one here. You got to get one.
Possession arrow in favor of UNCG. Next foul by Wofford will result in two free throws no matter what. About 16 seconds or so separate the game clock and the shot clock.
Well, a situation like this, we're going to see, I think, one of two things. Either that ball screen play for Dickey, where he's able to get the screen from the guard to go to the hole, or a little sideline pick and pop action for Galloway to get a three in the corner. Go for the win, or at least the lead.
Galloway 2 of 4 from the floor. All attempts have been from beyond the arc. Offered one of their last nine from the floor. Spartans haven't scored in their last almost 4 minutes, and we've just been sitting here at a two-point game. So 12 seconds left. You've got some time, but this play's got to develop, though.
Yeah, neither team is towards the end of the game. Seems like they're starting to hit E. Even Wofford's one of their last nine, so been a defensive struggle for sure.
Wofford trying to halt a three-game losing skid. They've won four straight against UNCG. Miller off a screen right side. Miller spins in the paint, goes up. Off the glass, no good. They'll battle for it. Ball out, and last touch by Wofford. With 17 seconds left. And the Wofford bench wants him to go to the...
Well, it's good, because if this is Spartan ball, they had no timeouts left. So Coach Miller, instead of having to call something, can actually draw something up here.
Tough look there by Wofford. Hard to tell who hit that ball last.
Yeah, so this what this did was give Coach Miller a timeout.
And they're going to play on. Looked at it really quickly. So it comes down to this here.
I think Wofford would have been better off just setting up the defense and just playing it through at that point. 17 seconds, have the last shot.
On your home floor, we'll see where the Spartans go. Will they go back to Miller? Dickey, back door to Miller, goes up, reverse layup, it's good!
Back door, 14 seconds. 14 seconds, gotta find Hoover.
Spartans have a foul to give. And a timeout by Wofford here with 7.7 seconds left.
And again, I think that's an advantage Spartans because they have a foul to give. Now Coach Miller can talk about it. Great backdoor play from James Dickey. Isaiah Miller, all the help side defense was up playing the three-point shot. Isaiah had nothing but a clear lane to the basket. But again, I think this timeout, I think Wofford would have been better running their play, a little dribble handoff or something, some action to Hoover. Because now UNCG can set up their defense.
Well, the first game went to double overtime in Spartanburg. Are we headed for extra time?
If you're a Spartan fan tonight, if you're a Spartan fan, you'll take it. You'll take it at this moment. Well, hey, at least it's one thing. The Spartans aren't going to lose in a last-second 94-foot shot. At least that's not going to happen.
Which has happened twice to them this year. Again, possession arrow in favor of UNCG. Now, that key stat is the foul total, what you talked about. Yeah. Only five team fouls for UNCG. They can afford to let Wofford make a pass or two, maybe one, and then you can foul to just disrupt the rhythm of that pass, right?
And Wofford has a lot of good offense here. They got some sets coming up. They're going to look at Hoover, obviously, but you know, with Goodwin, they had that isolation the last time, so they, maybe they run a lot of fake action for Hoover and Stump over there. Meanwhile, they slip it into Goodwin.
So here we go. Crowd standing here in the Greensboro Coliseum. 7.7 seconds left. James Dickey is on Goodwin. Isaiah Miller is on Hoover. Here we go. Wofford just does get it inbound to Murphy. And the ball knocked on the deck. Spartans were trying to foul. Hoover will launch it. And we'll go to overtime.
Great pressure defense that time. Again, that's why I think Wofford would have been better off not calling the timeout and just getting into their offense, because UNCG's defense was locked and loaded.
Boy, Massey, who was so aggressive, almost came up with the steal. Went off with...
And if Galloway didn't slip, he made it come up with that.
Might have been able to come up with that, and then Hoover just has to force one up.
And a great closeout, great recognition from Isaiah to close out tight on Hoover to make him put the ball on the floor, which is something he doesn't want to do as much as just catch and shoot.
Why not go to overtime? First one was double overtime back on January 4th. 98-92 was the score in that one. I don't think we're going to get to 98 or 92 for that matter.
I don't think we're going to see 90s in this one.
But who does the overtime period favor here now? Who's going in? Who feels like they have the momentum in overtime?
Well, UNCG scratched and clawed somehow to get back in this game with some key defensive stops, some big-time rebounds, and making just enough shots at the end. You know, Hoover, like you said, is kind of gotten into a lull. He hasn't made any in a little bit. He's starting to feel it, just being tired, being out there for so much. He's been out there for 34, 35 minutes at this point. So depth-wise, I think it's the Spartans that here are starting to feel pretty good, but they've got to execute their offense. They can't just be standing around and kind of going one-on-one. They've got to run plays. They've got to run sets and get some clean looks. You can see here again, good defensive stand there from UNCG. You can see just the look on the Terriers' faces. Heads down, bowing down. You know, that advantage Spartans.
Well, fouls became a problem in the first meeting as you went into overtime and double overtime. And as we look at the foul difficulty, Goodwin has four for Wofford. Nobody else sniffing foul difficulty. And for the Spartans, James Dickey has three.
Yep.
So you can play on. Dickey leading the way for UNCG, 14 points, 10 rebounds on a double-double.
Yep.
Hoover has 22 for Wofford. Goodwin has 15.
And a stat I want to point out is Isaiah Miller had five turnovers at halftime. He still has five turnovers. So did a much better job taking care of the ball, better decisions, not crashing into packs of people.
Now Spartans with only one turnover in the second half. So we will play overtime. Glad to have you with us again here at Greensboro Coliseum. And Wofford will have it to start off the extra period. Stop play. I'm not sure if they're discussing which direction. There's
9 seconds left on the shot clock, and 10 seconds have expired. I mean, I thought the teams would have gone different directions, because usually you go towards your home basket, your bench basket in overtime, and the teams went the other way.
Right.
So I don't know what they're talking about here. But they got arms around each other. Looks like they're talking about weekend plans.
Good crew here. Les Jones, Chris King, John Hampton.
Yeah, they had him. I thought they had him lined up to go in the wrong way.
Right. And Wes Miller is saying jump the ball up again.
Yeah, I'm not sure why he'd want to jump the ball again other than they lost.
There's
no reason to jump it up
again. Try to get the ball back, right?
I don't think it would have mattered if they went different ways. Unless you want to put 5 minutes back on the clock and start over. I think they're just talking about, you know what, let's just start it over.
I have to say, I don't know that I've ever seen this before.
No. That would be a new one. But you know what? Everyone makes mistakes. So you're trying to figure this one out.
And Jay McCauley getting the explanation here.
It looks like they are going to jump it up again.
Jump it up again.
And going to go in the right direction. So the last 10 seconds didn't happen. Or are they going to leave it at 450?
Well, we're going to head over to the scores
table. Yeah, reset the clock for 5 minutes. I have a...
It didn't happen.
Let's do it again.
Yeah.
Hey, this is the definition of no harm, no foul.
Let's get it right. And the Spartans get the ball, and Jay McCauley is really, really hot. And going at the officials here. He didn't like the toss, I don't think. Either way, good work by Wes Miller, the Spartan coach, to get another crack at it. Miller drives in, and the layup
going
is good.
Going left-handed. Good job, Isaiah.
So the Spartans strike first off the second jump ball, I guess, if you will, and lead it here by two. Miller with the steal. He'll crisscross down the lane, missed it, and the rebound down to Wofford.
Good transition defense from Wofford, who throws it 15 feet out of bounds.
Terriers give it right back.
Yeah, they got to get composure quick. I mean, I understand the awkwardness of restarting overtime, but they got a lot of basketball in front of them. They got to flush that and move on.
Dickey wants some movement. Off a screen from Miller, still with it on the bounce. Now to Hunter, shot clock at 10. Hunter rises, fires, jump shot is good.
Nice move going to his left, the way he likes it. Got to dig in defensively, find Hoover, find Goodwin.
Crowd into it, here's Goodwin. Dickey on him, 3:40 left in overtime. Hollowell. Wrapped up and a timeout by the Terriers. Spartans have seized this opening minute and a half or so of overtime to lead it by four. And a timeout by Wofford.
They're staying here with it. But Spartans really ratcheting it up to defense, but really so far, and it's Wofford just kind of back on their heels. See a good execution here. Isaiah going to his left, finishing with his left, everything with his left. If he starts pulling that out, then teams in the conference are going to have to play him straight up. Then he's impossible to guard.
Mid-range jump shot by Hunter and the four-point lead for the Spartans. Hunter now in double figures with 13.
If Isaiah is able to start going both ways comfortably, then teams are simply going to have to play him like Rajon Rondo and just play 7 feet off him, because it's the only way you're going to be able to keep him from going to the basket. And when teams do that, he still gets there.
He struggled tonight, 4 of 16, but made the one to tie it up, force overtime, and made the first bucket of overtime.
Well, UNCG has to continue to crank up the defensive pressure. You know Wofford's going to come out probably with their best play, screening hard, crisp passes, probably some counter action, so the communication has to be strong. Fighting over the screens has to be strong. Staying between your man and the basket has to be solid.
If you're just joining us, Wofford led by one at the half. Their largest lead was at six with about 6:45 left to go in regulation. for UNCG. Was able to force overtime on the Isaiah Miller driving basket with about 15 seconds left. And here we stand with 3:36 left.
The other stat I just want to point out, I mentioned it for Isaiah already, but the Spartans had 10 turnovers at halftime, which is extremely uncharacteristic for them. Only one in the second half in overtime. That's how you win games. Take care of the basketball.
And Wofford now with 18 turnovers. .330 left here in overtime. Hoover hunting a shot, drives in and fouled as he got into the lane. And really wrapped up hard there.
Hoover going real strong, going through Isaiah, going through Dickey. Just had contact, taking the contact. Dickey there just kind of caught him on a grab on a reach around, trying to get around the back pick from Goodwin.
Strong enough and alert enough as Hoover to make a motion to get the ball towards the goal so he could get to the free throw line. Now that's four personal fouls on James Dickey. So he has four and Goodwin with four for Wofford as Hoover calmly knocks them both in.
Yeah, he ain't missing.
Miller backs his way in on Hoover, gets all the way inside and scores over the top of him. He's trying
enough
to get himself going now.
He usually needs some help that time from the corner. You know he wants to take it. A little bit of a lapse there by Wofford, not collapsing on that drive.
Hoover drives, steps back, jump shot is short this time. Miller away with the rebound.
Hoover got away with a little push off there.
Miller's going to keep it. Attacks the rim, wouldn't go down. Dickey on the offensive glass. Massey had a notion,
good
and
decision.
Now he'll back it out.
Good decision. Get a good one.
Offensive good rebound one by James Dickey. Another opportunity for the Spartans here.
That's senior knowing time and score.
Miller turning the corner, muscles it up. Glass and good.
And reverse again, going to his left. Teams are forcing him to go that way. He's taking it and knocking it down. But got to give credit to Massey, not taking that quick three, knowing time and score. That's just a heads-up senior play.
Largest lead of the game for UNCG here at six. Stump open, his three is good,
knock
and an answer
down
by the Terriers.
A little overplay up top, couldn't recover quick enough to stump. You know Wofford's not going away easily.
1:50 left now in overtime. Dickey back to Galloway. Can he answer for three?
Oh, smooth. Rolls it in.
Spun around and gets the home roll. 1:35 and counting.
6'10 that can knock down threes the way he can. Tough guard.
Let's see. Dickey wrestled it away from Stump, but they're going to call a foul on James Dickey.
He went for it, just collided.
And that is the fifth foul on James Dickey. And he does so many things for
West
the Spartans.
West is going to take time to try to figure out who he wants. He's going to take advantage of this. That was tough. Though both players are going after it. It's just Dickey was kind of fading and fading, lost his balance, and fell into the Wofford player. You know, at that point, I think Dickey just has to try to maybe deflect and get back on defense, just not risk it. Because almost like he was a defensive back going to the back of the end zone, trying to come down with the interception. You can make that kind of contact in the NFL. They're going to call that here.
So Dickey departs, 14 points and 11 rebounds.
Now Coach Miller is deciding to go small here. And they took... I don't see Goodwin on the floor, so you can do that when Goodwin's on the floor, off the floor.
Well, 17 fouls, so Wofford should be at the line here to shoot one and one. And they'll get Stump there to shoot the free throws. And again, Wofford a really good free throw shooting team. And Stump, a senior with a 1-1. He's 86% from the line. He's been solid here tonight with 12 points, all on three-pointers, but missed the free throw. Miller is going to race it across the timeline.
They're going to foul Isaiah. Coming. They may go to foul Isaiah. They're trying to foul.
And they'll foul Massey.
Yeah, Massey's the one we want. He's probably the, between him and Galloway, the best free throw shooter we have on the floor.
1:12 left, so Jay McCauley's going to elect to foul here. And you know, UNCG, again, we talked about just 62% from the line.
Yeah.
Massey is 72%.
You got to knock him down here. There's just that's it.
He's 2 of 2 from the
end
line
of analysis
here tonight.
You got to knock him down. Senior stepping up.
'73-'66. Doesn't get the roll on the second. And a foul on Hunter. And if you're UNCG, that's the worst thing you can do right now. Stop the clock and foul. And it'll be Trey Hollowell at the line. Hollowell, a junior, shooting 74%. And another 1-1. Wofford will bring in Chavez Goodwin. As Jones subs out.
You know, interesting why they didn't have him on for offense. And now Spartans are going to go big.
Bring Abdul Salam in and Galloway
in there. And you know, in that case, they're just going to go to Goodwin. So what Mo has to do is, A, keep Goodwin out of the paint, play early post defense, and then just stay between him and the basket. Make him make tough shots.
Hollowell, first trip to the line. Box in the first.
Isaiah's got to get in there, too, and help Abdul Salam out.
Missed it. Rebound. Controlled by Miller. Trying to get away from the traffic. He'll push it ahead to Hunter. Under a minute left. And Caleb Hunter now will have two free throws coming up.
That was a great job by Isaiah to stunt around Abdul Salam. And a lot of times when bigs are battling for free throw rebounds, it's the first guard in that comes up with the ball. This time it was Isaiah. Big time rebound and a great job by Galloway to give Isaiah a screen so he couldn't get fouled to get the ball up the floor.
Hunter, 69% from the line, knocks in the first. Take out Abdul Salam, bring in Angelo Allegri.
I think at this point Spartans are playing to guard the three-point line.
Hunter go calmly.
Caleb
knocks them both in.
There you go.
75-67. UNCG. 50 seconds left. Long three by Hollowell is good.
Man.
Cuts the lead down to 5. Spartans get it inbound to Massey. Back to Galloway. And he's quickly fouled.
What a tough shot by Holloway.
Trey Hollowell, the junior.
Or Hollowell, excuse me.
Look again. Defenders all on him.
I mean, Galloway was right there.
Hunter. Can't play
Caleb
it any
comes
better.
In, challenges the shot.
But again, UNCG makes free throws, as you say. And Galloway now to the line. He'll have two again. Knocks
right
in the first.
Got to make them. Game on the line. It'd be nice to make them all the time, but have to make them here.
70% from the line is Kyren Galloway, another senior.
There
knocks
we
them
go.
Both in.
Making your throws on game on the line.
40 seconds left.
Stay on Hoover. Stay on Hoover.
Murphy's three is good. Wofford will not go away. Lead down to 4 now. 36 seconds left. And a foul off the ball as they grab Isaiah Miller to put him at the line. And Jay McCauley is looking in disbelief you'd say, well, maybe they wanted to foul Isaiah as he's the
if they're going to foul anyway.
Free throw shooter on the team.
Yeah, they're going to foul anyway. No clock, no time went off the clock. It's perfect.
And Isaiah, who has yet to go to the free throw line tonight. And 52% on the year.
And 8-for-9 last time he played Wofford.
Two free throws coming up for Miller. 6 points here in overtime for Isaiah. Had the bucket to help force overtime with regulation coming to a close. And a two-possession game here as Miller knocks in the free throw.
How about that? Crowd going nuts for that one.
Too strong on the second one. And Hunter gets it, goes right back up, and to the line he'll go.
Like I said, when the bigs are battling for blockout, it's usually the first guard in that gets the rebound. This time it was Caleb Hunter, first guard in.
Hunter on the left of your screen. No one boxed him out. He just walked in, felt some contact as Goodwin has now fouled out for Wofford. What an opportunity lost there for the Terriers. And now can Caleb Hunter step in? Hunter just made two.
Woof.
Gets the roll there.
The shooter's roll. Rattle, 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 go in. 6 point game, 33 seconds left.
Now, the way Wofford shoots threes, you want this one in. If you're the Spartans, they missed it. Ball tipped out and another offensive rebound.
Spartans quick to the ball again. You know, Scott, you made a point earlier about the team that was gonna be quicker to the ball, wanted it more. Get those loose balls, those 50-50 balls, who's going to be the victor. Last three possessions, been all gold jerseys.
Well, Wofford is really small. They have a really small lineup on the floor. And Hunter misses another one.
Yeah, I got to get this one.
You haven't been able to take advantage of these extra trips.
There it
there
is.
There you go.
Now a three-possession game.
Spartans want to pressure without fouling here. Wofford to stump. Hollowell, another three. Got another three. Cuts the lead down to four with 19.6 seconds left. Terriers finding the range from three here. Massey gets it inbound to Galloway. Galloway ahead of the pack to Hunter. Spartans will push it ahead and then Hoover will run down Caleb with 14 seconds left.
Good job of Spartans screening in that press attack. It wasn't cleanly set up, but they screened so well and cut so tight off the screens, they had an angle to get the ball in and then quickly moved it to get it out of the way.
Hunter, 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Swishes
there
in the first.
There
we go. Miller looking on the way his team has rallied to close out this game, force overtime, and trying desperately to close it out as Caleb
makes two.
Yeah,
I tell you what, they've needed all these free throws the way Wofford's shooting.
82-76, 11 seconds left, and a foul on UNCG.
Well,
and
the way
Miller
they've been shooting
free the foul.
The way they've been shooting three-pointers, it's not necessarily a bad thing. I know Isaiah was just trying to pressure the ball there, but
and this will be still a 1-1 for Wofford. Free throw by Hollowell is no good, and Miller away with the rebound and fouled in the backcourt. Well, the Spartans have, well, both teams have made it interesting here down the stretch. There have been opportunities for Wofford. They haven't been able to necessarily capitalize. The Spartans haven't been able to shut the door completely, but they've done just enough from the free throw line.
And it seems that as minute as this was, the reset of the overtime really got in the heads of the Terriers, the bench, the players, because the Spartans took one to tap, go down and score. The coaches are still upset over resetting overtime. There's a steal, I believe. They come back and score, and all of a sudden the Spartans have their biggest lead of the game.
83-76. No fouls here. Hollowell, long three. Is seconds left. Hollowell has just been lights out here in overtime, but not quite enough. UNCG in overtime. 83-79.
Wow. Wofford got one in overtime at home. Spartans get one in overtime here. What a hard-fought battle. That was definitely conference tournament level play.
So the Spartans will improve to 22-6 overall now and 12-3 in conference action. Wofford has dropped four straight now. They're 16-12 overall and 8-7 in league action.
And ETSU beat Furman, so Spartans are tied for second with Furman, and they got Furman coming up here in a couple games.
They certainly do. Well,